गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास।
टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर 8 दैट इज कंट्रोलिंग एंड इन दिस चैप्टर टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस व्हाट आर द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ कंट्रोलिंग, व्हाट आर द कैरेक्टर और नेचर ऑफ कंट्रोलिंग एंड द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ कंट्रोलिंग इन अ बिजनेस।
नाउ स्टार्ट विद कंट्रोलिंग। सो एज पर हेनरी, controlling consists of verifying whether everything occurs in conformity with the plans adopted, the instruction issued and the principle established. Means the plan which is taken for the particular job is executing well or not is checking that particular things is called and controlling. Now characteristic of controlling, or we can say nature of controlling, both are same. So controlling is a fundamental management function. So it is a fundamental management system. It is necessary for any planning or execution. Afterwards, essential function of every manager. Afterwards, controlling is a continuous activity. So it is a continuous activity. It performs every single days or in every stage of a planning or work. Afterwards, controlling is a related to result. Controlling has both negative or positive result. Or lastly, controlling is not necessarily looking back, it is an looking forward also. So why it is important, means importance of controlling. First one is achievement of goal. So achieving the target of the company or achieving the goal of the company, it is important to controlling over the subordinates or the worker. Afterwards, execution and revision of plan. So execution and revision of plan is a, we talk about the controlling. So this is an controlling. Afterwards, bringing order and discipline. So if we control our subordinates in a disciplined manner, then it will help us to grow. Afterwards, facilitated decentralization of authority, then promotes coordination, cope with uncertainty and change. Means certainly the changes may take place in the executed plan, so we have to change for the betterment. After easy work of planning by controlling, searching deviation and solve, directing work of easy controlling, and lastly coordinating work easy by controlling. Now it's time to discuss the relation between the planning and controlling. Both the things are not same, but what is the relation between these two we are going to discuss. The first one is planning precede controlling and controlling succeed planning. Afterwards, planning and controlling are inseparable function of management. This is inseparable. Okay, afterwards activities are put on rail by planning, then they are kept at the right place through controlling. So after planning, they put on the active roles, then the controlling take to the right place. So both are important in any organization to achieve their targets and the goal. And lastly, the process of planning and controlling works on system approach, which is follows as first the planning, then result and the correct action. Now steps in the process of control. So basically there are five basic and important step for controlling. That is, first one is getting a standard of performance. That means the first step of controlling is to set in standards of performance. A standard refer to those criteria on the basis of which the actual performance is measured. Now the second one is measurement of actual performance. So after setting the target, setting the performance, it's time to measure the actual performance. So the actual performance has to be measured on the basis of predetermined standard. As for example, the production target of X company has been set in term of ton. So the actual production of X company for a month should be measured in the term of ton. Now let us assume that the actual production of X company for the month of January is 4,200 tons. Now the next one, comparison of actual performance with standard. Now the third one is the comparison between the first and the second. First one is the establishment, the standard establishment, and the second one is actual performance. So third one is the comparison between these two. So at this step, actual performance is compared with the predetermined standard in order to verify whether is any deviation between the performance and predetermined standard or not. Deviation may be of two types, such as positive deviation and negative deviation. Now come to the fourth point, that is identification of cause of deviation. So what are the cause of deviation? That is, in any deviation is found of the third step, that means the previous step. The causes of that very deviation is discovered in this step. Now come to the last one, taking remedial action. So after executing and the checking the remedies, it's time for taking the remedial actions. Means what are the controlling steps we have to take? So in this step, remedial action is taken for rectifying the deviation in such a way so that the same deviation does not take place again in future, or we can say the same mistake or the same error cannot be found in future. So the last one is the taking corrective action if necessary. If something is went wrong in the third or fourth step, then they are going to take the necessary step in the fifth step, that is the last step. Now this is the short summary for this class. Just go through it and note down the important points in your exercise book. Thank you class. Just complete your work by today only and send it in this given mail ID. We also welcome you all to give your suggestion or feedback regarding this PPTs or videos. If you want any changes or add up any things, please write on this feedback.stmichael@gmail.com.